Hey, hey, it's Tamara here. Welcome to my channel. In this video, you will see me try to make a 3D game as an absolute noob in Unity 3D. I will show you what tools you can use to create a game in Unity, even if you're a total beginner. Also, I have a Patreon page now, so you can support me and get some extra content from me. Link is in the description. And let's get to the video. Long story short, I started making games not that long ago. To be exact, it's been 2 years of creating personal projects, but the development was going on and off. Most of the time I would spend on my university studies or side jobs or even personal drama. So just to be clear, I'm not a professional. If you have ever seen my devlogs, you already know that I use tutorials to develop most of the features in my games. I make mistakes and spend a lot of time fixing them. Sometimes I feel insecure about my game ideas, but the thing is, you can't become a professional without the learning process. That said, I have never made a 3D game before. Well, maybe except those super simple prototypes that Unity Learn teaches how to make. But I honestly don't remember a thing from making them. All of my projects are in 2D, and over time I'm getting better at those. You can see it from my past games, which I plan to talk about in another video, about how I started making games in Unity. Subscribe to my channel to see more game dev content, like tutorials and devlogs. This video is going to be a little bit like a devlog, because I actually tried to make a game with all those tools that I will be talking about. At the end of the video, I will show you a simple game that I made in just a couple of days. The first and very powerful tool is Unity Asset Store. A lot of people know about this place, but they don't actually harness the full power of it. The obvious usage of it would be to find missing pieces for your game, like art and music. I found a beautiful fantasy environment pack for my game and also a Toon Fox model with animations. I feel that I need to make a little disclaimer here. There is already a game about a fox which may seem really similar to what I show you in this video. But in fact, I have nothing to do with that game. I'm not trying to recreate it. It is just a coincidence that I found a really nice fox model and decided to use it as an example in this video. Back to the asset store. Here you can not only get graphics for your game, but also find pieces of code, and I mean literally whole systems to implement in your game. Asset store has over 2000 tools. You can find them by searching for a specific feature that you want to get, or check the boxes in the filter and explore different options. Look, we've got a multiplayer tool, third and first person controllers, different things for level design and many more absolutely free assets. The second thing that I wanted to do in my small game is player controller. And I decided why not use the well-known visual scripting tool for Unity. It is called Bolt and I've seen some developers promoting it because it is beginner friendly and can be used to learn the basics of code. I'm not a total beginner in Unity itself and I know a thing or two about programming, so you'll see my experience using it. I suppose it would be different for people who have never used Unity. To start, you have to import the package into Unity. You can find it on the Asset Store. I wanted to make a character controller with appropriate animations. I found a video from Unity Learn about how to make this with Bolt, so basically I was just pausing it and copying things. At the very beginning, that's what most of the game devs do. After some time, I finally got the flow going. I started to understand how to set up these elements. And this is what it looks like in the game. The fox can move in 4 directions, but it doesn't have any movement animations. So let's add some. That's better. An honest review about this tool is that you should expect to still put in the work to make a game. It might save you from all the bugs that you can get when you write regular code. However, there still might be errors, because you made the wrong connection and some parts of the code might not work as well. But for a beginner, it is good. If you want to continue developing games, you'd have to start learning the real code, because not all the things can be done with visual scripting. For example, I don't know if it is possible for a beginner to make a saving system with Bolt, and more experienced game devs would probably find it easier to do so with regular scripts. Another thing that you'd want to learn to make a 3D game is terrain tools. Again, this was the first time I used it, and it was very easy. At first, I made this empty map with some hills and mountains. For this, you would just grab a brush and lift a piece of the map upwards. After this, I added a colorful texture and the view began to look better. Now the fox can run around on the grass. But to make the game interesting, I have to add more things to the scene. and the terrain tools actually have a feature just for this. You add all the tree prefabs you want on the map and press place. Unity randomly generates them around your terrain. And another cool thing about terrain tools is that you can also paint grass on your map, or flowers. Now the scene looks much better. However, you might notice that the whole look of the game doesn't come together very well. Some trees are too bright, the amount of detail is different, and maybe the shadows are too strong. Part of the reason for this is actually because I use different asset packs to create the scene. And here's a pro tip, if you're using free assets for your game, make sure that they come together well. Or you can just use one pack, like I did later. But another reason is that I didn't use post-processing. This is a really important part of making your game look good. Although it might seem like it is just a bunch of filters, but in fact it helps the scene to look finished. There is just one problem. I couldn't get it to work in my Unity version, so this project is going to have to survive without it. Another tool to use for your game is NavMesh. It can help you to implement some enemy AI in your game, for example. And by that I mean chasing or vice versa running from the player. This tool creates an area based off of your terrain, where an agent can walk. If the player comes within a certain radius to an enemy, it will start moving towards the player. In other words, it is a pathfinding feature. No need to write complex pathfinding code, just use this tool. In my minigame, I used NavMesh to make the rabbit run away from the fox. I wanted to make someone to chase the fox to, but I didn't really have time to do so. And it turned out pretty good. The rabbit is simply chilling until it sees a predator and starts running away. In real life, it would run away like 100 times faster. Believe me, I've seen a real hare in the wild. But in the game, it is not easy to catch it either. Because there is no defined path for the rabbit, you cannot predict and cross paths with it. You have to chase it, and if you're close enough, you can catch it. And the last tool I want to share with you is a tweening engine. In-betweening, also commonly known as tweening, is a process in animation that involves generating intermediate frames, called in-betweens, between two keyframes. The intended result is to create the illusion of movement by smoothly transitioning one image to another. This can be used to animate your UI and even game objects easily. Before this tool, simple things like gradually darkening screen, floating button or moving text were really tiring to implement for me. I know two tweening engines that are used by game developers. DoTween and LeanTween. They are both available to download on the Unity Asset Store. I personally use LeanTween, but I think the other one is good too. It would be tricky to use with Bolt, but once you learn some real code and move on from that tool, you can easily implement tweening in your game. Now, let's look at what we've got for this game. We have a really nice nature environment, we have a fox to run around and explore the territory, and also a bunny which is trying to save itself from the fox. But why this game wouldn't sell? You've done a pretty good job at creating all parts of it. But the thing is, there is much more about game development than just coding and making things work. In a lot of cases, a good, successful game is a combination of team effort and creativity. So find a few friends and maybe start learning Unity together. And this is it for this video! Oh wait, before you leave, be sure to check out my Patreon page. It is going to be full of useful stuff for game developers, some behind the scenes of my work, and actually, it would be a great support for my upcoming game Lost in Athletes. Thanks for watching this video! Subscribe to my channel to see more game dev content like tutorials and devlogs. I'll see you soon! Bye!